Go High Level just upgraded the dashboard, and the new AI dashboard completely changes how you run your sub account. In this video, I'm going to give you a complete tutorial step-by-step of the dashboard, plus all of the AI updates so you know what's new and exactly how to use it.
So to access your Go High Level dashboard, you're going to come right in your sub account and you're going to go right down to dashboard.
So really quickly, if you don't know what the dashboard is, it is essentially a place where you will see all of the data from your entire high-level sub account in one place. So you can know how many calls you got, how many people opted in, how many leads you got, how your Google business is ranking on Google, just all of that stuff in one place. And this is really powerful, okay, not only for you to see what's working and what's not working very quickly, but for your clients to see what's working so they know why they're paying you. And later in the video, I'm gonna talk about reporting and sending reports to them to also help us, because this is one of the missing pieces I see constantly with agencies and their clients. They're not properly showing the data. And the cool part is you can customize these dashboards to look any which way, and you want them to look something more like this, where you're seeing all kinds of updates, revenue, conversion rates, things that really make business owners go, wow, this is why we're paying you. So this is one of the reasons why this is so powerful, and it's often overlooked, but we want to make it look something more like this. And this is a live dashboard, by the way. So what we're going to be doing in this video is I'm going to be going over how, okay, to customize your dashboard, what widgets to put in, and really how to clean it up and make it look better. But also, we're going to be going over this AI feature that has been infused into the dashboard, so the AI will help you read data and do all kinds of other stuff. So before we jump in, I just want to let you know, if you are interested in High Level, I have a 30-day free trial link right down below. When you sign up with it, you'll get access to my community, my snapshots, live calls, and so much more. And if you don't believe me, just click the link down below and you'll see what I'm talking about. So please, if that interests you, check it out. And if you have any questions, drop a comment down below. So the first thing to know is that you can have multiple dashboards in High Level. So you come right here and you click this button, you can actually add more dashboards. And you can create from blank, from the template library, or clone, and you can basically have multiple in here. So if you wanna just pick and choose certain ones, that's where you'll find them, by clicking this. But if you wanna edit said dashboard right here, we're gonna come right up here to click Edit Dashboard, and you're gonna be brought to a page that looks like this. So the first thing I wanna show you is that if you wanna delete or move anything around, it's very easy. You would come right in here, you'll click these three dots, and you'll click Delete, and it's gone. If you wanna move anything around, you will just grab it and drag it around. Again, you can only do this when you're in the editing. So if we come to save changes, it doesn't work. It doesn't do anything. This is what a lot of people do. They're like, oh my gosh, I can't edit. It's like, well, you gotta click edit dashboard first. But from there, we can move and really make this look any which way we want. But now what we're gonna do is we're gonna go over all the things you can add into your dashboard. So first off, we have widgets. And in widgets, the first thing you'll see are these chart types. This is just the way it's gonna make it look. So numeric, donut, line, bar, horizontal bar, and then table. Again, these are like different kinds of graphs like you see right here. This is a donut. You can choose how you want that to be displayed in each widget. And you just click as is there. But then you have basically the different widget parts you can add. And these are just data points on here. So each one of these will have a little number here, and this is the different points that you can add. So if we come into contacts and we click this dropdown, you will see almost everything on contacts right in here. Okay, so if you want to have a contacts count, we just click this right here. Everything looks good. You can click advanced setting if you want to add anything with date ranges. But then you'll just click save, and it will now pop up. So anytime you get contacts, they would be fed into the account. But see, that's how you just add one, but there's many to add. And it's up to you on how you want to make this look. But in contacts, we have basically everything to do with contacts in the account. You know, new ones coming in and whatnot. We then have appointments, so think calendars, booked calls, all that kind of stuff. We then have opportunities, so think like pipelines and sales, leads coming in, visitor data, how many views, what your funnel's doing, tracking, emails, bounced, open, delivered, unsubscribed calls, how many calls are you getting, you know, who's coming in, basically stuff like that, conversations, you know, where are you getting messages from, are they unread, you know, all this stuff with messaging, payments, so this is like exactly what you think, revenue, like if we come over here, you'll see, like it's revenue involved and stuff like that, where it'll show them like this is how much money you've made. And we have all kinds of stuff with opportunity status too, but that'll all be in revenue. And then we have stuff with meta ads, some basic general stuff, and then more Google Analytics. And the whole point about all of this stuff is you're just showing the data in an easy to see way. Because a lot of people will come on the High Level, especially your clients, and they'll come in here and they're like,
this looks cool, but what the hell does this mean? And they won't see anything because your dashboard doesn't say anything. When you create the dashboard properly to show them what's working, what's not working, it gives everyone a better idea of what's going on. So again, what you need to do is you need to just figure out exactly what data you want to have, and then you put it in. So if you want some pointers from the wizard and like, what would I do with a dashboard if I was first starting out? If you're working with a basic brick and mortar, you know, business, you want a couple key things. So first off, the first thing I would choose in this data point is I would do stuff with appointments. So show them how many different appointments they're coming in and stuff like that. Leads, show them the leads. You can put all kinds of stuff, calls to assign to, but most importantly, I would focus on the payments, revenue and, you know, people coming in, new deals, stuff like that, because that's what's really going to wow them. It's going to be like, oh, wow, we just made that much money. So that's what I would do if I were you. And again, you just drag and drop and put it right in like that. And again, for anything you're not using, delete it. Really important. Like, a lot of people will leave stuff with Facebook ads and Google ads. Don't leave that stuff. Get rid of that. Get rid of it if you're not using it, because all it's going to do is it's going to confuse people, especially if you don't have Google Analytics. Like, it literally just clouds it and it just looks dumb. Use only the things you're going to use, and you want the dashboard to be compact and show the data points you want to show. Really, really important. I see this constantly, and it's actually really frustrating, because a lot of people would do a much better job marketing if they showed the data better. So then what we can do if it looks really weird is we can come down here and we can go like that, and we can enlarge stuff. So we come right here, and then what we can do is we come right here, and we come to the side. Isn't that pretty neat? And we can do more like this and get this over here, and we can do a little bit of that. Yeah, and then that's what you can do. You can basically create the dashboard too by moving it around like that. So very easy, very nifty. I mean, again, like, you know exactly what to do. You come in, you drag and drop, you click if you want to delete. If you want to get rid of it, you click delete. And if you want to add anything, you add it over here. Very simple. If you guys have any questions, drop them in the comments down below so I can answer. So at this point, all you have to do is go in and create the dashboard on the data that you want to show your clients. From there, we then can edit the way we want the data to look. So again, widgets is going to be what data you have. Elements and themes is going to be the way you want the data to look. So if we come into elements, we can then add some stuff. So we can add stuff with code, which can be like Google Sheets, YouTube videos. We can add basic text. We can add images. We can add text box. We can add all kinds of stuff. And actually, one of the things I'd say that can help sometimes is if you come right in here, okay, and you add an image. So we're just going to come into the stock library. Say you uploaded something, but we're just going to type in logo. This is just strictly for test. We're going to pick the Lamborghini logo. What we can do is we can save. Okay, and then it'll pop up here. And what you can do, say this is their logo. Again, I'm just demoing. You can put their logo in at the top to make it look more official. Like, oh my gosh, this is their dashboard, which I'm telling you guys can be super powerful. You don't have to do this, but it's something you can do. Obviously, don't use the Lamborghini logo. Use their real logo. I'm just showing you for a test, but it can be very powerful. And it's just one of those things, guys, that's going to help tremendously in showing them the data, not telling them, which is what you want. So again, you can add any of these right here. Then we have themes. So this is just the different colors. Like, you come right here, you can change the colors, and you can even do a custom theme where you pick the exact colors, again, which helps a lot. Then you have custom metrics, which is just adding in certain metrics that you created from scratch, which can be a little tricky. But that is essentially how this dashboard works. It is that simple. So once you're all done, you just click save changes, and then you're good to go. But up here as well, you can clone this dashboard, duplicate to another account. This is really handy if you want to put in another sub account. Upload a dashboard template, and you can get from the marketplace. Set as a default dashboard if you have multiple, and then manage time zones and a couple other things like permissions. But then from there, you're done. That's all you have to do with your dashboard. Now what we have is we have this new AI feature that can summarize the dashboard. So if we come in here and we click this, what it's going to do is it's going to pull up Ask AI, and it's going to summarize stuff. And this is only going to get better. So as you see right here, it's coming in and it's talking about the opportunities are zero and there's no manual actions because this is a test account. So obviously there isn't a bunch of stuff in here. But the idea is it's going to come through and it's going to summarize all your data. And you can ask it questions like, well, how many calls did I get and where? And again, I don't have anything, so nothing's going to pop up in the sub account. But what it will do, when I've tested it on live accounts, it will go in and it'll be like, you got this many calls from here and there. And it's just going to make the data easier to read. And again, as you see here, it's not saying anything. It's going to only get better. I want to make this abundantly clear. Some of these new AI features, people are like, oh, that's not that great. But it'll get to the point where it can synthesize data much faster and it will understand certain things and give you better feedback and show you how to improve it. And then you also see, if you come down here, you can see little AI insights. You can click it and it's going to give you little AI insights on each individual bar or graph or whatnot. Like this, as you see right here, it's going to show you exactly what's going on so you know the whole story. So it's very handy. It's very helpful. And guys, at the end of the day, you want to show what you're doing is working. Because if you don't show, then you're just constantly telling them they don't believe you. That's why data is really important. But now what I want to do is I want to link a video at the end of this video that's going to go over reporting. It's really important because it's a separate video. But what reporting does is it takes this dashboard, cleans it up, puts it in a nice summarized report, and emails them every week or every month. So you don't have to show them or you don't have to give them access to high level. So that's what I'm linking at the end of this video. Please make sure you watch it because that is literally part two of the dashboard. And you have to understand it because it goes in a much deeper level on really getting this data to them. Because here's the other thing. They may not be coming into this sub account. They may not have access. But what they can have access to is a report that gets emailed to them every month, which makes you look better, like you're being proactive. But it also shows them the data. So it's one of those things too that's just super handy. And it's the cool too, if you have a bunch of clients, what you can do is you can create snapshots or you can duplicate this custom dashboard that you created to other accounts. You have the same kind of blueprint. And then from there, when you onboard clients, you get everything set up and your reports just go out like clockwork. And it's very smooth, it's very efficient, it's very powerful. So guys, thank you for watching this video. If you have any questions at all, drop them in the comments down below. If you are interested in high level and you want all of those bonuses I talked about, the calls, the snapshots, all of these goodies, please click the link down below. I'm not gonna lie, you won't regret it. It is amazing. If you don't believe me, look at the testimonials on that link. We have more than anyone else. It is insane. So again, guys, questions, drop them down below. Check out the link and make sure you watch the video that pops up at the end of this one because it's going to be going over custom reporting from the dashboard tab.